Selective Laser Sintering, or SLS, has been around since the late 1980s, and it's still a firm favorite today, mainly because of the versatility and the freedom of design SLS affords. The versatile 3D printing technology makes it possible to print complex, functional designs with no support structures needed. As such, SLS is one of the most widely used 3D printing technologies. You can find laser-sintered parts in airplanes, personalized consumer goods, production tools, and machine components. Let's take a look at how it works. As the name suggests, this popular 3D printing method uses lasers to successively bind solid powder particles together. The process takes place layer by layer on a powder bed, and the powder is self-supporting, which brings two big advantages. You don't need support structures, and you can optimize each build fully. Once the computer-controlled laser has done its job, the leftover loose powder is removed, and voila, there's your finished part. Because you can print multiple copies of the same part in one fell swoop, SLS is an industry favorite for series manufacturing, and the quality of the prints? Excellent. So this technology is suitable for a whole slew of durable, complex parts or models, including moving parts. SLS is also fast, which is why it's a go-to choice for prototyping and other one-off parts. For manufacturers, the ability to nest several one-off parts in one machine run means major cost savings. For designers, the capability to print living hinges or interlocking parts also means seeing design possibilities through a new lens and pushing the limits thanks to this newfound design freedom. Polyamide PA materials are most commonly used. They're durable, have excellent thermal and mechanical properties, and are also resistant to most chemicals. Additionally, PA materials can be combined with other materials, such as aluminum and glass, to gain specific properties. Unfinished parts typically have a grainy surface with smoothing, coloring, and other finishes available in post-production. When you start designing for SLS, there are a few key points to keep in mind. 1. A minimum wall thickness of 1 mm is recommended for polyamide and polypropylene, though living hinges are possible at 0.4 millimeters. Surfaces can become firmer or more flexible depending on your wall thickness. 2. Where possible, hollow your parts to avoid deformation and discoloration, particularly for large flat surfaces. 3. For interlocking and moving parts, a minimum distance of 0.5 or 0.6 millimeters between parts should do the trick for good functionality. So that's SLS, a versatile 3D printing technology that affords a lot of design freedom and produces functional, durable parts.